leaving Hong Kong, you?
Don't worry, it will be fine. So I'm Andrew and I'll be taking you through your speaking test. There'll be three parts. We'll go through the first part first. Okay, so part one, we'll talk about pants. Do you have any pants?
No.
No?
My parents are very scared about the fears of pants. This sheet of pants is really dirty.
Interesting. And what types of animals do you think make the best pets?
I think the best pet is the dog, because the dog is very long and it's very cute, and also it's very it's enough strong to protect protect me.
And why do people have pets?
I think some people don't live with family, so they are very lonely, so they need a friend to share happy and the life. So they need a friend and they choose this pet.
Interesting. And should dogs be left in the house alone while the owners are at work?
I think dog is depend on the house. They need the dog to protect the house, manage all the things. So I think we can leave the dog in leave the dog outside how to protect the house.
Is there any type of animal that you think you should not be kept as a pet?
I think it's some dangerous animal, like lion or tiger, because it's a loyal animal, it's not a pet. So if we live with it, someday it will bite me.
Do you agree? Okay. Let's talk about seasons. What is your favorite season?
My favorite season is summer, because in summer we can't wait to go to school.
Yeah, you have time off. Very good. Tell me about the different seasons in your country.
In my country, say for two seasons, it's not four seasons, or you can choose in a wet and dry season.
Mm-hmm. And how do the clothes people wear in your country change in the seasons?
Can you repeat the question, please?
In your country, how does the clothing people wear change in the seasons?
In the spring, people often wear the beautiful dress to enjoy the day holiday. And in the summer, people often wear some comfortable clothing to because in the summer it's very hot, and they need that clothes to make them more happy. Mm-hmm. And yes, and in the autumn, I think autumn is not really limited on the clothes. Because we can wear any clothes that they like.
That's okay, don't worry. What we can do is we can go on to part two. For part two, you're going to have 1 minute to prepare, so you can write notes on a piece of paper, and you will be discussing. You will be describing an old, interesting object that your family has. Okay, take another look. So you should explain what it is, where it came from, how long your family has kept it, and explain why your family thinks this object is interesting. Okay? You have about 1 minute
to prepare. What is the word object?
Object, it's like a thing. So this is an object. This is an object. An object can be something in your house. Understand? So an interesting old object in my house, for example, is a little statue, and it's made of ivory. It's interesting because it belonged to my grandfather when there were no ivory laws. Now there are ivory laws, and it's highly illegal. Okay? Understand? Your turn. You may write notes, yes. No, you lie.
It's lie.
What?
No, it's recording.
Okay. All right, that is the end. Okay. You may now talk for 1 to 2 minutes about an old interesting object.
I think my oldest object in my house is the television. I don't know when it had bought, but my mom said that when my sister born, they bought this television. They when 2004, the television in that year is very priceless. And but today we didn't use that television, but we still keep this that television like a lucky object. I take that television to watch some old film in the scene of the television. And I think that's good.
Okay, thank you very much. What we're going to do is we are going to just talk about a couple of things. So why do you think people keep old things from the past?
I think this is a very, the old thing in the past is very limited, and today we cannot create that thing. So if we have the old things, we can sell it a lot.
Yeah. It's like some wine. Some people keep wine for a very long time and it becomes worth a lot of money. I agree. So can you tell me, do you think we should keep all old historic buildings? Yeah? Do you think we should keep all old historic buildings?
Yes, I think this is very important because this building is the most important of one country. The buildings of the historic buildings tell us what is happening in that town.
But what happens if they're not using the building?
I think we cannot use the building.
Consider whether objects made in the past are better than objects being made now. Are things that were made in the past better than the things made nowadays?
I think in fact the object made now is very more better than we did in the past. But sometimes some things in the past make better than now, and in now we also use the object in the past, like you know the water.
I'm not sure.
Yeah.
Okay. So, can you tell me what types of museums there are here in Vietnam?
I think the biggest museum in Vietnam is Ho Chi Minh Museum. Mm-hmm. In that museum, it's got a lot of memories and a lot of history about Ho Chi Minh President.
Have you ever been to it?
Yes. Sometimes my parents took me to that museum and it's very interesting.
Okay. Can you tell me more about your experience?
In the museum is very nice, very nice. So I feel the the history of the past in this movie.
Interesting. What did you learn while you were there?
This is a lot of the story of when we fight with America or friends. And it's very interesting.
Fantastic. Alright, that is the end of our speaking test. We are now done. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.